Hi guys, and back to another ModShapes. My name is Alex Steele, and today me and tall girl Cindy are going to install an upgrade kit for the Tevo, and we're also going to install a filament sensor on the 3D printer, so let's get started. This Bowden tube is held securely by this 4mm industry standard integrated push-fit connector. Now, this also comes in two different ways, or three different ways, with a mount, without a mount, and with a mount for a filament sensor. And what's in this video, we're using the mount for a filament sensor. Now, if you do this, you may need to reverse your motor, but check your instructions because one size does not fit all. This kit does not contain a motor. The original motor is used. Here's a little filament sensor, and it's really cool. It is they call it the broken material switch line. And we're going to simply remove it from its current housing that it came in, and then install it in the Bondtech, because the Bondtech already has a space inside designated for the filament sensor. After Sydney pulls the previous extruder that we were using off the 3D printer, she then installs the new gear, which is more metallic, onto the stepper driver. Now this is really important because this is one of the reasons why we wanted this. This previous one was plastic, off it goes, and now the new metal one goes on to replace it. after everything was set up, we realized that there's a tiny bit of a space issue. The previous arm that we were using as the filament spool holder is just a little too short. And so in the next bit of video, I show you how I redesigned it so that it would fit the new situation. We needed just to be a little bit longer. So I just kind of created this Infusion 360, and then I generated another version of that's a bit longer, so it suits our needs and we have a little more breathing room when we're changing filament. It's really important to us that this amount of space between the filament and the extruder is as short as it can be, because the less space that exists there, the less chance of something going wrong with the printing process. So we felt like this turned out really good. So all in all, I would say this new extruder is hands down at least 1,000 times better than the previous one. And in closing, I'd like to say thanks for watching the video. This is Sam. Sam wants you to subscribe to this channel, so please click the subscribe button and go ahead and click the notification bell, because Sam would really appreciate it.